Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be discussing the Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta and Super Saiyan 3 GT Vegeta, the two new cards that are available on Dokkan Battle. Now, I was going to wait. I didn't know that this was actually available on Dokkan Battle Builder. Stupid me, I always forget to click on the SSR feature. That's this thing right over here whenever I'm looking at it. And I always forget because the newer cards don't have the RNTUR yet. So they're not going to display. So they are available. So this is going to be available today. It's actually on Thursday. So I'm going to put this video out today. So that way you can go over it. I have the LR Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku team building guide that's going to be out on Saturday. And then I'm going to be doing the regular Super Saiyan 3 building guide for the actual Super Saiyan 3 team with the Intelligence Bardock and stuff like that. That's going to be going out on Sunday. And starting Sunday, I'm going to be releasing my Dragon Ball Legends training videos, and I have a whole bunch of them already made. I have 4 videos created so far. I have one more to make, and then I have a news video that I kind of want to put out today. So I pretty much have 2 videos dropping every day for the next week until like at least next Tuesday. So stay tuned for all of that. And so let's jump into this video anyway. So we have over here Intensified Super Saiyan Vegeta. We already talked about him when he came out, but let's go over his abilities again. Leader skill, Super Saiyan 3 category, and physical type, key plus 3, HP, attack, and defense plus 50%. So not bad. You can do a little bit with him with the physical team building and stuff like that. We're not going to be doing team building in this video. We're more going to be doing linking buddies, so that way you know who he can link with depending on the team you run him on. Just because we're going to be doing the Super Saiyan 3 team building guide in a different video. Super attack, Gallic Shooting, which is weird. they should have called it Gatling Gun. causes supreme damage to enemy and raises attack for 6 turns. Passive skill, Super Saiyan 3 Strength. Attack and defense plus 70%. Damage received minus 40% when guard is activated, which means only when he's going up against intelligence units, which kind of suck. Link skills are Golden Warrior, Saiyan Warrior Race, Prodigies, Super Saiyan, Royal Lineage, and Limit Breaking Form. Now, it's awesome because he does have Prodigies, which does kind of counteract the fact he doesn't have Fierce Battle. He's only part of the Super Saiyan 3 category. HP max stats are going to be HP of 6873, attack of 7220, and defense of 4539. You can pause the screen if you want to read the rest of the stats for Duke. His 12 key multiplier is 140%, and his raise attack for 6 turns is a 50% boost per attack. So you might want to consider giving him some additionals. So he does have additional built in since he is a physical, but you might want to consider doing additionals because every time he super attacks, he's going to increase his attack even that much more. But it's up to you what you want to do. He doesn't have a Dokkan Awakening as of just yet. We do have some other stuff that I want to talk about, but I just want to go over the other card. I know it's a little bit out of character. I usually do the card that I talk about, the linking buddies. But let's go ahead and talk about the other Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta, because we also want to do a comparison to their other variants, because they do have the 2 strength variants that they have to compare with. So, this is the technique card, Into the Fierce Battle Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta GT. Leader ability is Super Saiyan 3 category and tech type, key plus 3, HP attack and defense plus 50%. Super attack, Gallic Gun. Supreme damage to the enemy. I said almost a Gatling Gun again. Raises defense by 30% for 6 turns, so he's more of a defender. Passive skill, Yearning for Strong Foes. Attacking defense plus 70% plus an additional 60% for 5 turns after being attacked. That's actually really freaking awesome. His attack is just a little bit ridiculous when you do that, and he has a built-in, well, the free dupe system is built-in crit, so that's pretty awesome. Link skills are Golden Warrior, Super Saiyan Prodigy, Royal Lineage, and Limit Breaking Form. Only category is Super Saiyan 3. Max stats are HP of 7338, attack of 7654, and defense of 3754. It's a little bit low on the defense side. A little bit low on all the stats, but he's also not Dokkan Awakened yet, so that's what we have. 12 key multipliers, 140%. His additional attack boost is calculated separately for a total boost of 170% for 5 turns. So that means he's going to be doing a hell of a lot of damage. I mean, just think about how much the Beerus does, and he's doing, 600,000 when he was on a 120, or to up to a million, well, when you have the dupe system and stuff. So he's going to be doing a lot of damage, especially on the Super Saiyan 3. So overall, that's what they are. Let's do a quick comparison real quick. Let me switch over to Dokkan Battle Builder real quick so I can get a close-up of this. Now, these are the 2 new cards on the left-hand side. These are the 2 OG cards on the right-hand side. Now, as you see, there's no links between them because these are the same cards. Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta, this is GT Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta, this is Super Saiyan Vegeta. As of right now, as it stands, pretty much the way it's going to go is if you have the 2 OG cards, run the 2 OG cards. If you have the 2 new cards, you can run them side by side. Now, why can you run these 2 side by side, and are they better than these 2? My thing is, I don't like the Super Saiyan 3 physical Vegeta just because he doesn't guard against all types. This guy does. He guards against all types, but it's only for 7 turns. But then again, 7 turns, you usually don't go that long in battles unless it's one of the brand new Dokkan events. But he is very, very viable, especially on something like Super Battle Road. This guy will be very viable, however, on Super Battle Road because his guard will be activated against people. He is physical because Super Battle Road, you're only allowed to take a specific type and attribute type. So he's a super physical, so you're only going to be going against extreme defense. So his guard will always be there. Plus, he gets attack and defense. If you keep him second in turn, he will be taking almost no damage. Thing is, this guy takes almost no damage against all types, so it really is situational. If you're going up against like Super Battle Road or an area where the bosses are mostly intelligence, this guy's going to come in very, very handy. The other thing about him that I like over his other strength counterpart is he has Prodigy. This guy doesn't. So while these two lack the Fierce Battle, because they have Prodigies, they can come in very handy. So they're only missing 15% attack buff. Now, if these guys keep their Prodigies and they get Dokkan Awakened, then these two are pretty much out of luck. That's all there is to it. These guys are pretty much out of luck. The only time you're going to want to bring this guy is if you're going up against like a Dokkan event that has multiple type, and you want to bring a little bit of strength on there, and he's going to do very, very well for you because of that specific purpose. But again, that's a very unique situation. This Vegeta is still really good, but I mean, it's a mixed bag between these two. He does a lot more damage. He does a little bit, but he has a little bit better defense. But his damage definitely, in my opinion, outweighs the fact that he has a better defense. He has attack and defense plus 90% at the start of the turn, and that's pretty much it. He has attack and defense plus 70% plus 60% additional attack for 7 turns. So overall, if this is going to be a shorter battle, I mean, especially because it's 5 turns, it really depends on how often he's going to be coming up. You might want to consider running this guy. But that also comes into play. What are you going up against? Obviously, if you want to bring this tech Vegeta, you're probably going to want to bring him if you're going to go up against an agility foe. Anything but intelligence. This guy will do decent damage against everyone except for agility. So if you're going up against agility, your chances are you're not going to want to bring his strength anyway. So this guy's almost, both of these, if you have both of them, they're kind of going to be situational based on who you're going to go up against. If you're going up against foes that it doesn't really matter, it's kind of a toss-up. He has a little bit more defense, but I don't think that it's outweighed by this guy's attack output, the damage output, because a 20% defense buff, I mean, it's really, while it's cool, if you're running on a Super Saiyan 3 team, it doesn't matter that much. Anyway, but this guy's really good, especially if you have him. Myself, I did not get lucky enough to pull either of them. I think that this guy should be your primary between the two GTs, and I think this guy should be your primary between running a good blocker between the two of these. And luckily, these two, I mean, they don't link for that great, but they still do link one key, 10% attack buff and limit breaking form. It does kind of suck because they don't have Fierce Battle, they don't have Prodigy, because this guy kind of just, he just screws you over on all of that. But then again, he takes no damage against anyone, pretty much. I mean, damage received reduced by 80% for 7 turns is phenomenal, and it's still relevant to this day. So that's where it's kind of like, it kind of sucks. If you're talking about links between the other guys, you have the new Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta and the old T5 link skills for 2 key, 20% attack buff, and 2,000, and 2,000 flat out boost. And then the same thing with these two guys, it's 20% attack buff, actually the same thing, 20% attack buff with 2 key and limit breaking form. So, I mean, it's kind of a mixed bag. This guy, his passive is awesome, but it's just that he doesn't link that well. So it's going to be harder for you to get off super attack. But with that being said, guys, it's really situational. All these guys are going to be situational. They're all very good. So if you have all of them, you know, very awesome. In terms of who you should run on a team, I mean, honestly, it's really just going to be based off of the situation, what type of team you're going to go up against. I think they're all awesome. I don't think this guy's worth super attack 10-ing. The rest of these guys may be worth getting to super attack 10 because they all do some nice buffs. And these guys don't even have Dokkan Awakens yet, and they're pretty damn awesome. They're going to become really good. And yes, I do think that they are going to be available on JP at some point. I don't know when, but I do think that they're going to come. Anyway, let's move back over here to the physical Vegeta. Best linking buddies in-game, the GT Vegeta, as we just talked about, the Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta, 5 link skills, which we already talked about, the Super Saiyan 3 EZA Goku, which is awesome. They link for one key, 700 flat-out buff, 10% Super Saiyan limit-breaking form. So link skills kind of suck there, but they are there. You do have the Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta, which is Prodigy Super Saiyan. So 20% attack buff, flat-out 700, and one key. It kind of sucks because there's not that many good key links there. You also have the Strength Vegeta, the one with the counters. He has 2 key and 20% attack buff, which is awesome. Royal Lineage comes in really handy right there. So if you're running a hero team, you could run the two of them together, and they'll do pretty good damage. And then we're going on to like the lower category stuff that are kind of decent. You have the Super Saiyan Blue Tech Vegeta, which is 120% attack buff and 700 flat out. The Super Saiyan 3 Strength Goku, which is OG, which is not horrible. Attack plus 80%, but that's about it, and he has older stats, so he's not that great. 10% attack buff, 2700 total of flat out boost and one key. And then you have Super Saiyan 2 Vegeta, which is 1 key, 20% attack buff, and 700 flat out boost. The rest of these guys on the bottom are kind of whack, so you can't really do anything with them, but they are there if you need someone to link with him. But yeah, you're pretty much going to want to throw that either the one that I had talked about before, the other tech one, which isn't here, honestly. It's kind of funny. They only link, they do link very well. Let's go back over here. They link for 5. I don't know why. Oh, you know why he didn't show up? He didn't show up because I have it set for TUR or higher. But he does link well with the SSR variant as well. In terms of mono physical, he does link, but only with 3 or more. The only one he links with 4 or more is the Super Saiyan Vegeta. Now, the Super Saiyan Vegeta isn't bad. He reduces the enemy's attack when he attacks them by 40%. So if you give him full additionals, he doesn't need the super attack. It's just his passive. He can reduce their damage by 80% for the turn, which is really awesome. He gives this guy 2 attack plus 10% for Super Saiyan and flat out 700. So that's not that bad. The best one that I can think of is going to be the Trunks attack plus 90%. At the start of the turn, Golden Warrior, so 2 key and 10% attack buff, which that is pretty damn. Yeah, it's not, 100%, I'm sorry, so he's attack plus 100%. Super Saiyan 3 Broly, the free-to-play Broly, he gets 10% attack buff, 700 flat-out boost, or sorry, yeah, 2700 flat-out boost, so no key there, that kind of stinks. Then you have the 3 support units over here. The 3 of them do link with him. They're going to be on rotation if you do it, off rotation anyway when you do it, so it doesn't really matter too much, but 2 key, 10%, and this one is 1... 10% and 700, and this one is 1 key, 10% and 700. So it's not going to be that bad. At least they'll be getting an additional key if you put him in the middle. Not horrible by any means. And honestly, because he does have the attack and defense plus 70%, when he launches a super attack, you're going to want him in the middle anyway. In terms of Super Saiyan 3 team, we already talked about it. The Super Saiyan 3 Goku, the Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta, and the EZA Goku are his 3 best buddies. Plus the new tech one that's out that I just don't have available because, you know, it's stupid SSR versus UR. But I'll just go ahead and I'll just throw them up in here real quick because available if you want to, you know, show me where you at. There you are. So we have them up. So there you go, 5. But yeah, now we're moving back over to the tech Super Saiyan Vegeta T. So he's over here. I like him. Best linking buddies in the game is the Super Saiyan 3 Goku GT. He does get some good, because he has the GT link, so he gets 2 key from there. So he gets 3 key total, Super Saiyan and Limit Breaking form, so that's 10% and 3 key, which is awesome. You do have the GT Trunks from the Strength team, which he's still actually really good. Attack plus 100% on his TUR. He has GT, Royal Lineage, and Golden Warrior for 4 key total and 10% attack buff. Heroes team pretty much, or GT pretty much. Then the other one that I really like, and a lot of you don't really run him or talk about him too much, it's the GT Vegeta from the World Tournament Rewards. He is so awesome. Golden Warrior, Royal Lineage, GT, so 4 key, attack plus 10%. And this dude, attack and defense, I think he's attack plus 100%. Attack plus 90% when HP is 99% or below, so he's still very viable. We already talked about the counter Vegeta for 4 link skills. That's 2 key, 20% attack buff, which is another really good one. And the OG Vegeta, which a lot of you hate. He does do 2 key though and 20% attack buff. He's not bad. Attack plus 70% at the start of the turn, and he's good for tech. So on a tech team, they're not that bad. And speaking of tech teams, in terms of best linking buddies, we already talked about the Super Saiyan Vegeta GT. He is awesome. I like him. You have the actual 120 leader. He links with 3 link skills with the Super Saiyan 3 one, that is. Not great. 1 key, 10% attack buff, and then the limit breaking form. So not that awesome. You have the Trunks over here. This Trunks is the attack plus 80% when facing one enemy. 2 key, 10%, so not horrible for Link. This Vegeta attack and defense plus 70%, I believe it is. 20% attack buff and 1 key. So yeah, attack and defense plus 70% when facing one enemy. And then you have this Trunks, which is a support unit, which gives 2 key. He gives 2 key. He links for 3 key and 10% attack buff. So he's going to be helping out that Vegeta if you have him on the same rotation. If you're doing a monotech. Like I said, you already have the Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta over here. I'll scroll down. You also have this Vegeta, which he kind of sucks. He's key plus 3, attack plus 2,500. And you already know this is the free-to-play Goku. High chance of attack plus 100%. So honestly, GT Vegeta would probably be his best linking buddy. And or the support unit, if you want to run a support unit on primary rotation like you do with the Super Saiyan 3. It doesn't link it hit off all the link skills, but key plus 2 is definitely going to be very useful, especially if you don't have that many people to link with him with that GT link skill. Anyway, these two will always be getting off super attacks if you link them together. Last but not least, for linking buddies on a Super Saiyan 3 team, the only two he has is the Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta, which no one's going to really run, and this Super Saiyan 3 Goku GT, which people probably will run, because he's actually really good. Attack and defense plus 90% at the start of the turn. He could be primary, he could be secondary, and they link for 4 link skills, which is GT for 2, Golden Warrior for 1, so 3 key total, Super Saiyan for 10%, and Limit Breaking Form for a flat out 2,000. So overall, not bad. You know how I feel about the different units. If you don't have the old, like the older ones, then the newer ones definitely come into play. They are very situational. They will definitely help you out. It's also really good if you have either of these, because you can have a really nice team going if you don't have the Bardock, because they are Super Saiyan 3 category leads. Plus, all of them do their monotypes as well. It's not fantastic, but you have some good choices to go there with. You know what I mean? Like, for Super Saiyan 3s, and then just for Mono Tech type, or Super Saiyan 3 and Mono Physical type, you have options. But anyway, guys, that is it. I really appreciate you stopping by. Hope that was helpful and informative. Between the two new cards, between their old one and the new one, which one do you guys think are the better card? Anyway, guys, thank you. I'll catch you all in the comments.